Hello, I'm Dr. Dennis McKenna, as always joined by Dr. Fred Venditti, our hospital system general director. Today is Tuesday, October 20th, giving you the update from Albany Medical Center. All right, Fred, let's jump into the COVID numbers and we'll pop up the first graph. I think you can see that numbers in the capital region, 8 counties, hospitalized patients with COVID is going up. That current number is 48. Now, this is Tuesday, tomorrow's our regional call. We're gonna hear from the area hospitals. But there's no question, we are definitely seeing an increase in hospitalized patients with COVID.
You know, Dennis, even though we haven't had our call yet, we've heard some information from a couple of the hospitals that they have seen some increase in admissions and their census as a result.
So. Let's take a look at our numbers here, and then we'll go a little bit deeper into the numbers. So here's Albany Medical Center this morning. As you can see, we currently have 12 in the hospital, 9 on the floor, 3 in the ICU, 1 on the ventilator. So Fred, if I'm not mistaken, all of those people currently admitted to Albany Medical Center are in the adult or older category.
They are, Dennis. We don't have any children or young adults in-house.
And that is important because we've been hearing on the news recently about maybe an uptick in the number of positive cases related to children. And what may be driving that is a different conversation. But as far as the ones that are coming into the hospital, it still appears to be in a population 50 and above.
That's generally. Right, Dennis. And I think we've only had one college student admitted, and I don't think that individual was terribly ill.
Fred, talk a little bit about the knowledge you have related to what's happening in the nursing homes.
So I think what's started this fall, you know, really started in a younger population, the school-age children, college students, but it's beginning to spread, I think, into that more vulnerable nursing home population. So in the paper this morning, there was an article, the Times Union, there was an article about Van Rensselaer Nursing Home having, I think, 10 positive patients. And there's been an outbreak down in Columbia County at a Ghent assisted living facility. So I think we're beginning to see spread beyond that healthier population into the vulnerable population, which is something we fear as we go forward.
And there's no question, we've been doing these videos since March, and we've always talked about being sure that we do everything we can to make sure that the vulnerable population is protected as much as possible.
Really,
and I know
important.
People are trying very hard to do that.
It's really important.
And then flu, we're watching for flu activity. We'll hear on tomorrow's call if we've seen any. Still small numbers. And the flu season typically can begin in November, December.
That's right. We're at prime time. Could easily be going on, but we haven't really seen any.
Okay, very good. I said March because actually back in 2009, I think H1N1 started.
That's right.
It
started very late in the season.
Started
You're absolutely
the season.
Right.
All right, let's talk about the governor's travel advisory. And typically on Tuesday, we get an update from the governor as far as states added to the list or taken off. So what's the update?
So Dennis, Puerto Rico, Maryland, and Arizona have been added back into the list. If you look at the map,
let's pop that up.
You can see that basically the coasts are green and everywhere in the middle of the country is red. Interestingly enough, both New Jersey and Connecticut would qualify under the governor's rule set. He's not put in place a travel advisory. Obviously, there's so much back and forth between the metro area of New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut. It'd be kind of hard to do that without closing down the economy.
Okay, so there's the map there, and it's important for our workforce because it means that if people are traveling to the states on that list, we test them before they come back, and
That's
we have
right.
the ability to do that 7 days a week, including the weekend.
That's right.
Let's shift gears and go over to nursing. And there's three, I think, really good news stories to talk about on the nursing front. Let's start with our chief nursing officer search and update. And I think you have some updates for that.
Yeah, Dennis. So today we did the fifth remote interview.
Right.
Some really good candidates. Next week, we'll actually bring the first candidate on site for the second round of interviews. So I'm very excited about that. So that's already been arranged, and we're working on the second individual who will come on site the week after that. So we'll begin to do those second rounds. I am very confident that we're going to have a new chief nursing officer with the beginning of 2021.
That's wonderful. And looking at the CVs of the applicants, it's going to be somebody who's very strong.
Some very talented people, just really very impressive individuals have applied for the position.
Excellent. Second topic. As you know, we have over 2,000 nurses that we employ here. We have the best nurses in the whole region, of that I'm certain. And we're always needing to hire nurses. And you set a very, I thought, aspirational goal of hiring 100 nurses in 100 days. We talked about that many times here on this video. Did we reach our goal?
So, Dennis, we actually reached our goal quite some time ago.
Yes, we did.
And as you know, and I've told the audience before, we decided, well, let's change the goal.
Right.
So instead of 100 and 100, we made it 150 and 100. And so shout out to the team working on this. Today we signed our 150th nurse as part of that initiative. Now it's day 102.
Right.
So technically they didn't hit the goal, but they still get credit.
A plus.
They still get full credit.
A plus.
Full credit.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's really quite remarkable. The team has done a wonderful job. You know, Dennis, it's kind of interesting. There's been a lot of chatter out there about recruiting nurses by people who kind of don't understand the situation.
It's hard work.
The market is a tough market, and it doesn't seem like they recognize all the hard work that our team has done to recruit these 150 nurses.
Yes.
We've been working really hard. We're trying to get more nurses into the medical center, and frankly, we've had a lot of success in the last 3 months.
I agree with you 100%, and a nurse is not always a nurse a nurse. Sometimes it's a pediatric nurse, sometimes it's a surgical nurse, sometimes it's somebody for critical care or the emergency department. And so, we're recruiting nurses, but many different types of nurses.
We're kind of a bunch of small specialty hospitals because
right.
we're so big and we do so many very, very important, very specialized right. things. Not only do we need specialized physicians, but we need specialized nurses.
Right.
Makes it harder.
And we will point out today that, as I said, we have the best nurses in the region. And in point of fact, a couple were recently recognized. Annually, the Times Union has their Salute to Nurses. And I think we had a couple who were identified.
That's right, Dennis. So that was published on Sunday, and we had two nurses in our system that were identified in the top 10 nurses in our region. Heather Brown, who works in the Pharesis Unit here at the Medical Center, and Debbie Streets, who's the lead surgery nurse at Glens Falls Hospital. So congratulations to both of you. Great job. Absolutely terrific nurses, not only those two nurses, but all our nurses.
Absolutely. So the Albany Med Health System recognized there as well. Fred, last topic. We said this many times. We are an academic medical center. The care we deliver on this campus or that our affiliate physician groups care for patients here is different. And today's a pretty exciting day because there's some new treatment that's going to be delivered on this campus today using one of our affiliates. And I think you used the word, it's revolutionary in many ways. What are we talking about?
It absolutely is, Dennis. This is cancer care that we're talking about. And it's a treatment called CAR-T, chimeric antigen receptor T-cell therapy. So in simple terms, if you have a certain kind of cancer, we can harvest your white blood cells, send them off to California to be re-engineered genetically so those white blood cells recognize your cancer as foreign. And then we reinfuse those cells back into your body and they actually fight the cancer directly
right.
because they recognize those cells as foreign. So Courtney Bolumbo and the group at NYOH
yes.
are doing this trial. The first patient today is being reinfused with those engineered white blood cells. They actually have another patient scheduled next week and another patient the week after that. This has the, I think, the opportunity, Dennis, over the next decade to completely change how we treat cancer.
Right. And so you mentioned Dr. Bolumbo, who's the chair of our cancer committee. You and I have both known her for many years.
Yes.
She's extraordinary, as
She's
is
terrific.
All of the doctors from NYOH who treat patients here. But credit to them, this was a big lift to get this done, and
yes.
there's a lot involved in it. And
they've been working on this a long time to get this rolling. So.
How many places would you say in the entire country are doing this type of work?
Really a handful, Dennis, mm-hmm. in the Northeast. It's really all the large cancer centers
right.
that are involved in this kind of treatment.
All right.
And this is a research protocol,
right.
So very rigid and rigorous in its performance.
Yeah. It's fun to be able to use this video to
yeah.
call them out.
So shout out to that whole team.
So Thursday is when we'll come back. We have a couple groups, members of our workforce who this is their week or month, and so we'll talk about them this Thursday and the type of work that they do so we can give them the credit that they deserve. I think that's it. Anything else?
I think you've covered it, Dan.
All right, very good. So back again Thursday. We'll see you then. We ask that you once again, please take care of yourself, take care of each other, and we'll see you in 2 days.